Hey everybody, it's BZ here, and welcome to another episode of Techtonica. I just went back here to Lima for a little bit, had the production going pretty good. Am I going the wrong way? I think I am. Haven't been on here in like a day and a half, so I kind of got lost where I was supposed to be going. It must have been this way. Came back here to get a whole bunch of resources, start get production going over here at Victor. I was also looking at the little side quest, or the main quest I should say, on the upper left. Now apparently I'm actually deciphering codes by placing these power blocks and crank generators. So I have no idea what that's all about. But what I want to do first, just because I can, because I have the resources, we're going to go over here and we're going to upgrade this 500 and 500 and upgrade terminal. And let's see what that gets me. 2400 iron, 2400 copper, and 180 plant matter frame. Terminal upgraded. New technology. Interesting. Oh. Alright.
Put those crank generators and power floors to use, Breaker. To make plant matter frames, you'll need planters and threshers, and they only run on electricity. After you grow and thresh Kindlevine, you'll need to thresh the Kindlevine stems it produces a second time to turn them into plant matter fiber. And then you can either craft the plant matter frames by hand or build an assembler to do it for you twice as fast. And that's a lot of new tech to activate. So if you haven't built a core composer yet, now is the time.
Alright, so where do I start? Let's go ahead and scan all things first. I thought I scanned these in the last episode, but didn't scan them. I was looking for that too. Grab that and that. I want to clean up a few things and scan whatever I can. I'll bring you back when I'm done. Okay, I'm back. I managed to clean up both areas where the copper and the iron is. I got all the pieces for the long inserter and the assembler. Got a little bit of a joke about how assemblers can be produced dime a dozen and you're one of a kind, yada yada yada. Anyway, we got to go ahead and place these things down now. So I need the power blocks. She wants me to get
crank generators to power it. After that, you'll be able to dump cores into it and never worry about placing them one at a time again.
Okay.
Core composer. Supply with research cores via belts and inserters for automatic placement and availability.
Okay, now the question is, where do I want to do this? I'm gonna have machines up there. Maybe we just come right across here. Oh, I like that. I like how it tells you how many too. So I got 250. Might as well go do like a 20 by 25. Or no, that wouldn't be right. 25 by 10. We can always make more of them. Come on, where are you? Where's that magic number? Fine. Go there. Okay, what's next? So now I gotta make
signal deciphered. Ingress AS2013. Report to production terminal radio for triangulation.
One step at a time here. Okay, what am I actually doing here? I need crank generators. Alright, let's see what I need for the crank generators. Where would they be? Oh no. Oh my god, lots of good stuff. Wow. I guess I have to research it. She was talking about something about putting the core composer down, so maybe that's what I gotta do. Energy, yeah, okay. So let's check this thing out. Oh wow, that's big. Good thing I made this platform big. Does it have to be up here, or can it be anywhere? That is the question. Let me through. Yeah, it needs a floor, because I think it needs power. So I will put it right on the corner here. Oh, wait, can I do that? Make some cores. I don't know where I'm going to put them for now. I don't know how this thing works. Hold on, I think I got some crank generators, did I not? I don't think I did. Yeah. Let me look around. I'll see if I can find anything. No, I didn't get anything. But anyways, let's go ahead and use my mouse wheel buttons for a change. Or mouse buttons, I should say. And go ahead and place it. I don't know why I didn't want me to place it there. I'm going to put them here for now. Once I get the research for the crank generators, I'll put them into the core composer. Alright. Go ahead and we will unlock that. Interesting. We'll find out how this works out. Hang on. I'm sorry about that. Anyway, I need a crank generator. Do I have one yet? Oh, there it is. It's over on this slot. So I don't know how this is actually going to work. Oh, wow. Oh, it doesn't actually go on there. Okay, what am I doing wrong here? I think I gotta make it bigger. Hold on. I see what's going on. I don't know if it's picking up in the video, but there's actually a sort of a hashed area around the buildings when I go to place it. So this actually needs, if you look on the left side there, the core composer needs 3 blocks around it. This actually needs just 1 block at either end. So I can place it there. All right. So go ahead and activate the crank, and it should power this. Now, how does this work? What do I do with it? Because I know I'm supposed to... I think I have to actually use an arm to put him in there. Let me get that. Actually, do I have anything? Oh, I do. Alright, let's try this. Okay, it's going that way. I do have to make... Oh, I do have containers. Do I? No, I don't. Alright, we will make 1 container. And 3, 2, 1. Oh, you won't do that there. I have to do conveyors. Oh my god, you serious? Alright, fine, we'll do conveyors then. Alright, and... Inserter, can I place you? No, I can't. I don't have any floors. Can I build any floor at all? Let me see what I can do. Okay, that'll work, except for the fact that I have the conveyors facing the wrong way. And let me do that. And now I gotta make some more cores, so I will be right back. Okay, so I got a few set up already, so let's see what happens when I throw these in. Again, I have not, don't have no idea what, how this works. I have seen that I have placed the conveyors the wrong way. Aw, they're flat, they're not round. I think I got that going the wrong way too. Yeah. And it needs more power, apparently. Oh, I do have to make 5. Alright, well, let me make 5 and I'll bring it back when I'm done. Report to production terminal radio for triangulation. Okay, so I had to place a few more cores down to research the power floor because I had to expand this a little bit. So I've got 5 of them here. I have not actually powered all 5 yet. So let's activate that. Oh, I like that. The floor actually lights up too. So I need to get 5 of them going for this. Oh, and I just heard something drop. Oh, this might be... Okay. Aha. Oh, that's cool. Alright, good. I made a whole bunch. Let's see what happens. Let's actually make some more, why don't we? I went over there and I grabbed some more ingots. There was about 800 of each. I was running out of fuel. Cool. I like that. Automatic placement of research. Good use of our time. Anyway, okay, so what do I gotta do next? I gotta supply that. I gotta Processor. Okay, well, anyways, let's go see what this thing actually has to say. I'm sure I've got about a million beacons unlocked now. It's a matter of figuring out which one to go to. What do you want? Mind the voltage. Oh wow. AS. No idea what the voltage is. Oh, I guess we have to supply power to it. Is it saying anything else?
Signal triangulated. New location added to HUD. Exceptional dimensions.
Okay. Anything else? No. Okay. Okay, there's two that we have to go explore. So what else do I have to do here? We gotta get plant matter frames. Alright, let me have a look at what I gotta do here. Okay, so I decided to do a little bit of exploring, and I was checking out the map here because I forgot that we had it. And I was looking at it, and I saw this channel down here, and I started thinking, well, what's this? And I realized that I can actually see, like, different buildings. Oh, and the power just went out. But yeah, there's buildings, and I decided to go down and check it out. There's a little cave, and I came across this thing, and I have absolutely no idea what this is. Looks like some sort of mining rig or something. But what I need to do is, as you see on the on the left and on the tasks, the bottom one says to build accumulators. And I was looking at the accumulator, and the accumulator actually will allow me to power the machines like the drills and the smelters using power and not plant matter. So I think I gotta find them. I found zero, and I gotta find 10 of them. So I was looking around, and I was hoping I'd be able to find them.
It's like a standard field setup for drilling a new shaft, but there are two problems with it. The first problem is that we're at the end of the line. The only thing below here is the core, and the shaft doesn't look like it was cut large enough for freight anyways. The second problem is that nobody asked me first. That's a much bigger problem. If whatever they were up to here was bad enough that they thought I would report it, it must have been very wrong or very dangerous. Or both.
Interesting. Figure out what that is. There's more iron components. I can scan the lights and all that stuff. What is this?
Identified. Xeno material containers. No contents detected.
Yet. Any more? Pick one of them. And let's see what this is. Suit speed 3. More drill stuff. Anyway, I'm going to go look around and see if I can find these accumulators. I have a feeling they should be here because the research tree tells me it should be in... where is it here? Energy. Accumulator should be in Victor, so it should be in this area. So I'm going to look around and I'll see if I can find it. Okay, so I've been looking around and I haven't really been able to find much. And then I was kind of looking at the marker and I looked inside to look at my map and I saw these buildings and I thought, wait a minute, those aren't my buildings. So I'm looking around and then I realized that it just happens to be behind this wall. If I go over on this side here, the marker follows. So that means we got to break on through. See what's on the inside here. Shouldn't have to go too deep. You can actually see on the mini map that I'm actually digging through. Oh, there it is. And I'm gonna assume those are the accumulators I'm looking for. Oh.
Hey, a battery pack. Sorry, an accumulator substation.
There we go.
Try to go easier on the recon slang. It might help you guess at what those signal names are short codes for. Accumulators won't matter for a while, but get in the habit of scanning anything and everything you find in places like these. It can only help.
Good thing I was looking at the map. Alright, well, this is exactly what I was looking for. It'd be nice if I could pick up the floors. I wonder if I can. That's a lot of floor I could use. I have been looking around too. I think I mentioned that there's a bit of a cave area around here. And I'm going to just take all this stuff anyways because, hey, it's free resources. Oh, well, let me take that one. But yeah, I've been finding a couple of iron or a couple of copper deposits that have been hidden in caves. I've only seen one iron and I believe I have found limestone. But I'm not 100% sure on that. Anyway, what's this? High voltage cable. Oh, one big cable. This is nothing. What else do we have here? I'll go pick up the rest of these. Let's go investigate the room here. See what we got. Interesting light. It's almost like it's a balloon.
Still around, they wouldn't be here. These places were pretty much built and left alone.
And this is going to be a second research core, the blue ones. Okay, and what do we have here? We have full speed 3. Jeez, I haven't even upgraded it once yet. Crank generators, I'll take that. And that is a hover pack. Ooh, hello. I got some tools to make, toys to make.
This sector was a dream come true for hydroelectric power. It isn't surprising that we took accumulator construction seriously down here. I faintly remember power sources in other sectors were even stronger, but they also tended to do things like explode, set things on fire, giant clouds of poison. You get the drift. You can't go wrong with a good old-fashioned river.
Oh, that is true. Well, that's cool. Now, I'm wondering if I can actually dismantle these things. Just let me inspect them. So let's see if I can... Yeah, it won't let me take them. Or the floor. It's a shame. Oh, well, I got 300 power floor out of that. So that was good. Anything else in here I can... borrow? Until I feel like giving it back? No. You never know. They might hide something on the roof or in the back. Then again, I could, could technically just dig out the wall and do it myself, but anyway, that's exactly what I was looking for. So, let me get some stuff together and I'll be right back. Okay, well, I decided what we're going to do is I think we're going to look at going ahead and unlocking the assembler and the biobrick, because I'm going to need fuel. I did do a test with the drill and the smelter, and they can't actually get powered by these things. At least not these ones. I'd imagine there's going to be a variation upgrade eventually. There's the thresher and the planter. I do have to find these things, and I have a feeling that they're going to be over at that one over there. Anyways, let's go ahead and place some floor down, because I got to start producing processor units in an assembler. Now, I have 300 floors. If I can get up there, that's a problem with using a mouse wheel on multiple hotbar rows. And go here. And I might want to tap into these ore veins, get this process, you know, at least pumped up on here or something. But anyways, let's see what I need for the assembler. Go ahead and make one of these, or what the assembler needs to make things that I need to make. And apparently the assembler can, it's basically twice the crafting speed. But I imagine you'd be able to set it to like full on auto too. Why is it not showing the side powered? I have no idea. Oh, maybe it's what's actually connected to the power network. Let's just place this and see what it does. Oh, I like that. It has a little heads up. Alright, what was that little thing? Did I get an achievement? Okay, plant matter frame. Plant matter fiber. Okay, plant matter fiber comes from... Where do I get plant matter fiber? Oh, I guess that's the other things, the thresher and stuff like that. I need a processing units. And what are those things? I think we might have to go exploring. Let me look at this and I'll be back. So I was looking for the processor units in the assembler. And I couldn't find them, so I thought, oh, I should go unlock the accumulator. And then I realized, oh wait, they're here. Good thing I had the research points for it too. Now, where was that accumulator? Oh, yeah, it's under here. I need 40. Alright, let me craft a few more and then we'll get on it. I'm thinking too, like, to find the other units. I think I gotta go over there because that's why it's giving it to me here. Maybe we'll have a quick look at the map again. See what else we got by nearby. What is it over there? That is to my left. Oh, wait. Is that where I came from? We must investigate. Oh, no, that's here. Investigation complete. Yeah, I guess we'll, I'm gonna do some research and, be back when we start working our way to the other one there. Okay, well, I figured while it's doing its thing, we will go do ours, and we'll go do a little bit of exploring. And we'll just cut ourselves right through the wall here. Now, let's, I wanna make sure I'm going the right way. I know which way I'm going here. There's a compass. Does it show which way the base is on there? No. So I'm gonna be heading straight north from here. Nope, I'm not gonna be heading straight north. I'm gonna be going west, more or less. Well, I don't know how much digging I have to do, so I'll bring it back when I'm done. Okay, well, I just broke through that wall and came across more of these heavy cables. So maybe we'll go and check these out. Scan them, because we're gonna need them eventually. At the same time, too, if I already have it, I get resources. I actually thought I was pretty much sure. I'd imagine this isn't going to be too far, though. There was a bit of an opening here and some lights. So maybe just up and around the corner? Maybe. Or... that's going the wrong way. I'm going to get lost here. Oh! Can you see it on the map? That's not the map. That's the map. So I see something. Now how do I get in there? This might be the best way, I think. That's why we have it. Yeah, it likes to move on you. Alright, well, I got a little bit of digging to do. Actually, we should put it through pretty quick. And overheated. Let's check that map again. Okay. Right here. And wait for it. And there it is. We got through. Restoring power to LID. Is that what this is? Alright, what do I gotta do here? Alright, door unpowered and secured. Alright, so I gotta supply power to this thing? Door unpowered and secured. I have no idea. Can I get through to the on the other side? That's what I wanna know. So I know where it is now. No, you don't give us a mining duel if we can't go mining with it. Alright, I'm gonna cut here and I'll bring it back when I'm through. Okay, so she started going on a bit of a storyline about camping and all other stuff. I wasn't really paying attention. I have looked around. Apparently I have to open this somehow because I have not seen any way in there or any prompt or anything like that. I do have this to scan. Just pack size, and there's this one. I have a feeling because I think it's the last piece item I need for this that I might actually unlock a way in. No, apparently not. I just got platform plant matter frames out of it. But apparently, I gotta supply power to it. Mentioned something about the voltage.
Door unpowered and secured.
Not too sure. Anyway, I'll bring it back. Or I could pay attention to my task list and actually see at the very bottom there says craft, place, and use a crank generator to restore power to the large industrial door. Reading helps, kids. Aha.
Power restored.
Genius. I'm an absolute genius. Free stuff.
Warehouse. I knew that gigantic door was a good sign.
Oh, wow, there's a lot of stuff in here.
For some basic electrical machines, especially those planters and threshers on the racks. Pick up anything else?
Yeah, that's kind of what I figured. All right, I got some scanning to do. I don't think there's actually anything in these. It's gonna be a lot of materials though. Anyway, as they say, scan all the things. Okay, well, I just finished clearing an entire row of these filtered inserters. That's the purple ones on my hot bar there. And she came up with a story about machine fragments and stuff like that. But I do believe I have found the planter. Planter 1, planter 2, planter 3, planter 4. And I found out that if you keep holding it down, eventually that note gets, that sound gets higher and higher. Or at least it was. Maybe it was just my imagination. And of course I can't run because of story mode. What do we got? Current generators, accumulators. Cool. It's upstairs. Thresher. Haha. It's quite the factory in here. I wonder this way up there. Keep trying to hit shift because I want to run, but it won't let me. No, I guess not. Well, we found the tech we were looking for. Can I get in here? No. Can I get up top? Maybe. Jump on there, and then jump on here, and up here. Then we sneak in here, and we steal all the good things. Oh, hey, an office. Oh my god, I got a lot of looting to do here. I'm gonna do some stuff, and if I find anything interesting, I'll bring it back. Atlantum ingot. There's one I haven't heard before. Funny how I didn't notice the stairs when I first came in the door. Anyways, I have gathered everything I can. I got up to the other door there on the office, and I gotta bring processor units over. So we gotta get that going eventually. But I came here for the thresher and the planter. So I gotta go check this out. I do need these seeds for them. Thank God I have been getting them. I gotta find my way back. What was it? I said I was heading north, right? No, hold on. I went west, so I had to go back east. Yes, basically straight east. Be nice if I could pan the map or zoom out even further. Anyway, I'm gonna find my way back home. That is. What's that over there? Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's that way. Anyway, I'll be back. Okay, I'm back. So I have been looking at the research tree, and I do have enough to get all this done. So I need 30 for the thresher, 25 for the planter, and that'll allow me to make the plant matter fiber to make the plant matter frames.
Thresher. Supply with resources to produce a variety of organic goods. Electrical power required. Task inbound. Planter. Supply with seeds to rapidly reproduce fully grown flora. Electrical power required.
Okay, well, thank you for telling me saying just exactly what I just said. And I was looking at the processor unit. The processor unit needs electrical components, which needs iron ingot and copper wire. So that copper wire also needs ingot. So I'm going to have to set up a few of these to actually automatically produce these. And then also we got to get into this. I need plant matter and limestone. Now, let's actually see what this planter and thresher does. So I'm going to go ahead and go into my inventory, build one of those, and see what each one of them does. I got to place some accumulators down too. Now, I think they all have to be on the same grid, don't they? Okay, so it doesn't actually have to be connected. Interesting. Well, let's actually place the other one down. Because I need the hop space anyways. Okay, do that. And now, see what this... What is this, the planter? Let's see what it does. And where is my inventory? I need a thresher. Yeah, gotta click and then click again, not click and drag. And I can just figure out what each one does. This one just needs seeds. Does it need power or anything? I have no idea. And now what does this thing do? Not much yet. I guess I'm waiting for this. Oh wait, I gotta... Let me bring it back when I figure out what this thing actually produces. Well, you can actually see what's growing. It just happens to be these things here, which have been around. I'm curious to see what the output is. 47% there, so let me get that up and going, and I'll bring you back when that's done. Okay, so apparently I just get the seed, the vine from it. I don't actually get any seeds, but maybe this will produce something for me. See what this outputs. And I get seed. Okay. Does that give me one every time? It does.
Mission initiated. Be advised that all generated outputs must be relieved for production without disruption.
Yeah, in other words, saying that it has to be taken out for it to continue. Alright, so now, I should be able to, actually. I could actually do it in here. Why is it not letting me make that? Oh, okay, yeah, it's letting me do it now, I believe. Can I do it in here? I'm out of fiber. What do I have? What did I pick up? Oh wait, does this actually go back into a thresher? Okay, now what's this? Now what is the extract for? Oh wow, that's a thresher, right? All right, so now I can do that, and then that goes into here. That actually, I can probably make it in my inventory. Yes, I can. All right, well, that means I gotta get that set up, and the seeds just go back into the planter. So let me get something set up, and I'll be back. Okay, I'm back. Something I ended up researching that I couldn't figure out how to use was connecting the generators together. Now, I actually had a two-block gap between them, so they weren't connecting, but if you have one block gap, then they actually connect together. So if I go ahead and crank one, it'll crank all five on this row. The accumulators have accumulated quite a bit of power, and they don't seem to be using it, so that is good. Now, what I have done is I have crafted a whole bunch of power floors. Now I want to tap into the iron over there and tap into the copper behind me. So what I think I might do is see if we could build a little platform across here. And then I'll probably end up having the miners going into smelters and then just working their way through. Because all this has to be fed into the whatchamacallit there? The terminal. Yes. Okay, we'll do that. And we'll go over here and we'll extend this by a long shot. Why not? She said there used to be a factory the size of a city down here. We might as well bring it back, right? Alright, so let's go ahead and craft. Craft six drills. We craft six assemblers. And I do have lots of conveyors. I have lots of arms. And I have containers. So I'm going to go ahead and get this all placed down. I'll bring it back when it's all up and running. Okay, I am back. I think I have everything ready to go. I've been trying to increase production on Kindle vine stems, just because we're gonna need a lot of them. Let's bring the recipe up here. This is what I need. For that, we need three of the plant matter frames, which need six of the plant matter fiber. Now, I was trying to get four of these hooked up going off the same thresher, but I realized that getting the seeds going around isn't going to be the easiest thing in the world, because now we're starting to get a bit of a backlog. Not backlog, but they're ending up in the wrong spot, because I don't think I have any rationing sections or anything like that. Actually, you know what? I just remembered that there is a... I might be able to do it this way. If I do this... Actually, we'll go back one. Oh, it's not going to work. Hang on a second here. Could have sworn I was getting junctions before. Maybe that was a different game. I don't know. Anyway, I was doing it that way. That way, when this is full, It's going to grab one, and then the rest are going to go through to the other side and fill that one up. And so I've got technically 9 seeds going through, and they're all ending up in here. All right, so I do have the copper and the iron set up. I don't really have much for fuel at the moment, but I have been trying to use the biofuel bricks, or the bio bricks, and they seem to be holding up for a fair bit. These ones actually got biomass, and this is actually the wrong area. Plant matter, not biomass. Yes, I do have the copper over here. The copper is going to be important because that's what we need a lot of. And as you can see, I have the biofuel bricks in there, and they're holding up, but you know, I might have to look at getting automation of this. This can actually be made from this, I believe. Let's get back into the crafting menu here. Yes, that can be made from plant matter fiber, and plant matter fiber gets made from the thresher, which gets made from kindle vine seeds. So yeah, it might have to be a huge farm on that one. But with that being said, let's actually go ahead and get this copper up here now. So let's go, and we need an inserter. Oh, that's not what I wanted to do. Come on, wrong button. There we go. Conveyor, yes. Now, I think there was, the automatically adjusting terrain levels. Now, where do I want to get this set up? I think I might actually bring the conveyor right in here. Actually, that's another thing I did too. If I look at my hotbar, I made more of these. Made more accumulators, and I even made a whole bunch more generators too. Four and five. It's going to be generating a lot of power, and hopefully we can store a lot of power at the same time. Alright, crank you. And crank you. And crank you. Okay, let's see. Now, I believe the 80 is combined. So I think I had 16 before. It holds up a little bit, but we're not producing anything right now, so that's going to be the issue. Do I have anything here? No, let's get rid of that. Oh, that's not what I wanted to do. And, alright, so now we need assemblers. So, let's look at the recipe again. So, I want these. So I need plant matter frame, so I'm gonna need another assembler coming off of that container. And then I need electrical components, which are gonna be may as well go one and one, I guess. Alright, assemblers. Okay. So assembler number one. I'm gonna take that one too. That's actually, it makes more biofuel for me. Let me get those placed down and I'll be back. Okay, I'm back, and I am just about ready to put the last piece of the puzzle in. So I have got everything sort of set up. I want to make sure that the plants are still growing. Okay, so still 4 in there. We still have one there, and one coming out. So it should be going good. I had a bit of a recipe issue. I forgot that this was actually making stems and not fiber. So the stems have to come out of here, go into another machine to get pulverized into fiber and also into this dust. Yes. And just because this is actually taking a little while to do, I'm going to do that. Put another conveyor here. And hopefully that'll work. Yes. That'll get a little bit better. So yeah, I got them filtering. This is taking out the stems, which is going into, or the fibers. Yeah, it's, the recipe set wrong. Yes, you want fibers. Yes. So you're going in here, you're getting automatically turned into fiber bricks, which are going to be outputted to the end of the line here. In here, I have the copper coming in the back side here. You're going to make copper wire, which is going into here, which is going to be making electronic components, which is going to go in here and combine with the plant matter bricks to make, or plant matter frame to make processor units. Yes. All right. So now all that's left, besides getting an adequate fuel source going, is place you there. Let me bring you and Can we not, can I not actually bring you all the way up? Oh, that kind of sucks. Alright, let's see if I can get a bigger mouse wheel, I think. Are you actually gonna let me build down here? Hang on. Okay, you are there. Go one more and then up and see if it'll do the conveyor for me. There we go. About 20 million hotkeys for this game. Perfect. Alright, get rid of that light. And I have been trying to craft lights. They are not cheap, unfortunately. Now that's just lazy. I do like how you can bring up the build mode, though. That is actually really handy. Let's see here. I am going to this machine here, which means maybe we will do a bit of rotate there, and I didn't mean to click, and then we go down this way and then another inserter there. No, that's the wrong machine. Let me put it back where it belongs there, just because I haven't actually done the auto bridging conveyors. Okay, that should be everything now. So these are making wires, which is full. This is making electronic components, and this is going to be making processing units, which end up in this container at the very end. So this is going to be a little bit, so I'll bring you back when I have enough to maybe open up that. What do we need those process units for? Oh yeah, the door. Let me take care of a few things. I'll be right back. Okay, I do have everything all done now. We are up and running, and we have a whopping 38. And I actually need 40 to open that door. That's what we're going to do. And achievements have been firing off left, right, and center. That was me trying to get a better thumbnail. But what I did do is I did actually find the hover pack research. And I do have it. Now, you activate it and it just hovers you above the ground. And that's about as good as you'll get. If you go off that surface, it'll keep you to the same height you were on a new surface, but not when you go back and then you hit space and you drop down. So there's really no way to actually increase your height after you've already gotten up there. Like I said, you just hit down and you can go on top of the machine, go on top of another machine, and then you can go up and get an even higher view. But that is that. I have been trying to keep these things running. I definitely have to build a huge bank of accumulators, but the power hasn't been running out too much because we're not using too much power. But we are good to go, so that is 42. Now, where was that door? I think it was this one over here. No, it's going to be to the west, I do believe. Yes. So let's investigate, shall we? It was right over here. And for the longest time, I was trying to figure out how I was supposed to make soil, and I was trying to do different things in different machines, and nothing was working. And then I realized I could actually make it in here. Where is it? Soil. Yeah, plant matter and limestone. Anyway, yeah, I think it was... Was it down here? Yes, it was. Let's go investigate this. I believe this is the one that needed the processors to open the door. Nope, there it is. That's not my hole. Where is it? Back here. Oh yeah, I forgot about the jetpack. Ha ha. There we go. No, actually, this isn't what I needed to open, was it? Oh yes, it was. That's right. And that's respawning here. Okay. Yeah, I just had one of those moments. Alright, and that's where the jetpack comes in handy. Alright, now we drop down. We can go ahead and repair this. Repair access door. Alright, now they're talking about...
Scan those mining charges. And that computer has something up with it too.
Yeah, I was just about to say, they're going to be handing over some explosives to us. Anyway, let's see. Explosive mining charge, okay.
Something keeps pinging this terminal with the most irritating supply requisition I've ever seen. Wait, it's the Excalibur. But why would they requisition? Hold on. It's not a requisition at all. Someone is using the supply management system to send a distress call?
Automated distress call received. Waypoint added to system display.
An automated distress call? I've only ever seen one of these in training. It shouldn't even happen. These beacons only light up when someone becomes unable to trigger a distress call themselves. Or worse. We need to find the source of that signal. Somebody needs our help.
And we will do that in the next episode. We're just going to go ahead and finish doing everything. Craft speed 2. Well, I guess that's personal crafting. What do we get here? Just data book entry for inserter. Now, I don't see anything else here. I think that's about it. And sure, now the door is open. But I think with that, it'd be a good time to call this one. What I'll do is between now and the next episode, I'll see if I can get a better fuel situation set up for the miners and all that stuff. Actually, you know what? Give me that. It's mine. And in the next episode, we'll go check out the emergency beacon there. But anyways, I thank you all so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed. If you did, don't forget to leave me a like. And as always, I'll see you in the next one. Later. I forgot I could fly.